many conferences for Queen Wilhelmina, the peace conference of 1970, organized through marriage with Prince Henry, and he was always there. At that time, a person like Baron van Palland owned a large house in The Hague, and he had three castles. This is the one still existing, it's Castel de Rijn, or the town hall of that municipal community. Here you have Waardenburg, a medieval castle, and here is his son at Molenzicht. That was the third house they had, and Molenzicht was demolished in the 1960s. All these four people were painted by Discart, which meant, of course, that Discart not only maintained his network, but all Discart liked the family, or the family liked him. But of course, there was a connection. This was their house in The Hague, not this house. This is the German embassy now in The Hague, but it was this house, but I couldn't find it anymore. But this is the house from Palland till 1920 in The Hague, at the Lange Vijverberg. Here is his brother, another brother. And then their daughter, this is from Hardenbroek, and here you can also see the paint and the date. J.B. Discart, 1903. She was a great friend of Queen Wilhelmina, and the whole correspondence between them consisting of about 600 letters is in the private royal archive in The Hague. But someone who's interested in Discart is allowed to see it. There are, here are their two children. It's a colored photograph. Here is the daughter, so I think they quite look good. Their son, so the young person here, died very young on a sort of infection. It's a disaster for the family, and this painting was posthumously done. Yeah, this is Mrs. Schimmelbenk van de Oude Hussen van Kattendieken. And it's on the front of the book. This guy painted three members of the family here, another lady, and also Mr. Hugo Hussen van Kattendieken, a banker later on. One of the curious things is that his son and other family members are still alive, and we've taken pictures. Do I look like Discart has painted my father in 1917 that type of jokes? But these paintings are all in private family hands yet. This is Reinier Paul van Wildrecht, one of the richest persons in the Netherlands. They owned Castle Broekhuizen in Leersum. It's now a hotel. I'm writing my dissertation about inheritance of Dutch art collections after the introduction of the Napoleonic law. And the problem was that Reinier got in the end five daughters. So their Rembrandts and so on are rather dispersed in all sorts of collections, also public ones, but also private ones. This one was painted in 1905. And one of the interesting things is that his father kept a diary. Broekhuizen was burned down in around 1911, was rebuilt, so it looks rather old, but it is not that, that old. And at the moment, Rudy Eckhart, who has written the introduction of the book about this car, is writing again about the famous collection Paul van Wildrecht. This is another Countess van Limburg-Stirum. She was married with Count van Wieland, one of the founders of the Van Wieland Foundation in The Hague, which supports art publications and so on. This is Mrs. Schevening. She was an American, and I continue a little bit. And that she was painted probably by Discart because her daughter, this is painted by de Laszlo, was married to a Count van Limburg-Stirum in Noordwijk. Now, as you see, this is not a Discart, it's a Laszlo. It's far more exuberant. She has a nice dress, roses on the head, and so on. And the Laszlo was not only perhaps better, but also far more expensive. If you would pay for a Discart around 100 English pounds, then the Laszlo would cost you around 300 English pounds, which was quite a bit of money at that time. But there could also have been another reason. If you compare the painting of the daughter and the mother, what of course is striking is that this painting is far more sober. It's also a beautiful lady, I think it's beautifully painted, a pearl and so on, but it is not exuberant. And one of the questions is that Holland at that time was predominantly a Protestant country, while a devout Roman Catholic like Discart has painted all these Protestant Dutch nobility members. I don't know it, but it's striking that it's done. And I think one of the reasons could be that he has painted more solely. Now, this is an earlier painting of by Cornelis Bisschop, painting who lived in Scheveningen. This was her house in The Hague. It's now the, not the Taiwan embassy, but I think there's a very Taiwan representation, high office or something.
Yeah,
an enormous house, and also inside still beautiful. Now, her daughter again. Then in 1909, he painted King Albert of the Belgians in his year of inauguration. He's dressed here in the uniform of a field officer or as a lieutenant general. So the Queen said, the way up in Brussels. This is Baron Bout. He was procureur general, attorney general in Amsterdam around 1910. And he is interesting because there is no correspondence anymore that exists in archives of Discart. But he kept the letters of Discart to him. The letters of Bout to Discart are no longer there, but in the National Archive in The Hague, the letters of Bout to Discart to Bout are there. So we know something about how many times they posed, what time they took, and so on. This is his wife, this is Bout Huygens, a Dutch nobleman who was at court, Baron van Hardenbroek. His wife was Mrs. van Hardenbroek van Limburg-Stirum. She was a sister of the Bransen van Limburg-Stirum family, so they were all family members altogether. And she had a very smart expression, and at that time Queen Emma was rather around in the Hague, and one said of her that she had a smarter expression than Queen Emma. But that was really so, I don't know, but it's certainly their reputation. The painting was painted around 1910 in The Hague. This is a Portuguese lady who was married to the Marchand in Alsembourg. They had a castle in South Limburg. Mm-hmm. This is Mrs. Van Tuyl van Sieroskerke van Palland. It's a pastel of around 1920. Here with her eldest son and her husband, and she asked to paint their three children. Here Max, their first daughter, Elizabeth. And Elizabeth later was married to Mr. Van Vredenburg, who later on was also the administrator of The Hague, and wrote a book, The Hague Doesn't Answer. So, as you can see here, it's a painting which is done more or less in the style beginning part of Deco. Mm-hmm. This painting is newer, but more classical. And here you have the son of Mrs. Van Vredenburg van Tuyl van Sieroskerke. He is 86 now. And I made a picture of him in his house in Heemstede. He lives in a care apartment now, but is still as sharp as a needle. And he helped me to discover around 26 Discart just around the country. He didn't know where the portraits were, of course, in the air, but with my niece in that council on the ceiling. This is the Groenings van Soelen family, other brother. This is their house in Ridderkerk near Rotterdam, Huis ten Donk, an 18th century country house. This is their house in The Hague, now the British Embassy, Bouwvoorhout 10. And this is the painting of Wenk van Papendrecht.